There's precious little that I can't do now if I really want to and I'm willing to put in the time and the effort to do them.
I have RP, retinitis pigmentosa. It is a degenerative condition. Most people by my age don't see near what I see right now, so I feel a bit fortunate in that regard. It's supposed to be something passed through the genes, but there is very little trace of it in my family. It was formally diagnosed about 25 years ago. And at that point, I functioned pretty well in society. I could drive, I could work, I could go to the movies, and do a lot of things, you know, play some limited sports. And that has depreciated over the years to a point where I was able to drive until about 6 or 7 years ago. I probably shouldn't have been driving then, but I was able to maneuver from here to work and back and did almost no other driving. I was able to work until about 3 years ago.
I do a lot of cooking and cleaning around the house, but I do what I can do. Some things I obviously can't do, and I need a little help here and there, and some things are just a waste of my time. I can grill almost anything. Most of those things are a matter of time and temperature. So I know how long I can put something on, when you have to turn it. When it comes to something like chicken, I can tell by the weight it loses while it's cooking and how stiff it feels if it's done or not, and I usually do really well with that. I do all of my own pool maintenance. I can find the skimmer basket and the pump and motor, and I work the vacuum. I can do tactually, and I don't have any issues with them. The biggest problem with the misconception of the sighted world is that they really don't think that there's very many things that we can do. I was actually at Leader Dog for about 3.5 weeks training with Mission, and we left there a little over a year ago, and it's been a great experience. So they have different dogs of different abilities, of different strengths and weaknesses, of different dispositions, and they try and match up the best dog for their student. And I had quite a few people that were not my trainer look at me walking with Mission while I was there, saying that they couldn't believe how good a match that we were. I just use him for what I know that he can do. And I don't have any other expectations above and beyond that. You know, when I get to an intersection, I don't expect him to know if we're supposed to go straight, right, or left. He guides me. And I can give him certain directions, and he knows from that which way he's supposed to go, and it's as far as that. He can be a little bit of a puppy sometimes, but he almost never barks, and no matter what riles him, it's never as much as you'd expect any other dog to be riled, and he is very easily calmed down. And it just gets better all the time. The more the dog works with me, the better we know what the other one wants and what the other one needs, and we work together as a pretty good team. For the most part, I've always believed that I lead a charmed life. I have good family, good friends. I have enough money to lead a decent lifestyle. Yes, things could be better, but I'm sure that I still lead a better life than probably 90% of the people in this country and probably 99% of the people on this planet. So I don't feel like I'm losing out that much. I have a lot more to be thankful for and that I have than the vast majority of the people around. So I don't have those kind of why me feelings. I kind of feel fortunate in what I do have.